Art is swimming with the fishes for this week's In Focus. Jamil Donna shows us how this Grand Rapids angler is making eye-catching lures and decoys that will have fish biting in no time.
When you walk into Danny Rudd's studio, the sea of lures hanging from the ceiling is overwhelming.
These are big lures.
Lures of all shapes and sizes, painted neon colors, some with polka dots, some with stripes.
It's colorful, it makes a little noise.
But for this full-time craftsman, this is just a basement.
Seems normal to me.
Root started making fishing-friendly art 3 years ago.
I used to spearfish when I was younger, and I started making those just for the heck of it.
After some time passed, he decided to quit his day job and make angler art his new career.
They're real decoys.
Although alluring, Root's art is also functional. His lures are used for bigger fish like muskies and northern pikes, and his decoys are for spearfishing.
So this little Bart here is a cutie.
But some have trouble tackling the idea of using art as bait.
I gave two friends this one, and they won't use it because they don't want to lose it.
And even though people may not use Rudd's decoy art for fishing, he still wants them to work. So he built himself a fish tank to test them. And as you can see, this piece of art is working perfectly.
Man, he looks so good. He looks good enough to eat.
But before it's time to go fishing, there are several steps to getting these functional fishes to swim. First, he carves. Then he hammers, sands, and finally paints.
So today I'm going to get these done for this.
The process can take months, and while it looks like hard work, for Root, it's just a hobby.
Now, wouldn't that be a neat fish?
Even though he sells his art to numerous shops and galleries in the area, his pay is no catch of the day.
This doesn't make enough to buy pizzas once a month. That one works really, really nice.
So whether art or just a hobby, used for functionality or just decor, these fancy fishes are sure to lure you in. For this week's In Focus, Jamil Donath, Lakeland News.